Hello students, we start the subject software engineering. Course code for this subject is MSCS 1130. Software engineering is the branch of computer science which deals with the analysis, design and development of a reliable and quality software. So the prerequisite for this course is knowledge of basic concepts of computer science. So the objectives of studying this course is first, to understand the key concerns that are common to all software development processes. Second objective is to select appropriate process models, approaches, and techniques to manage a given software development process. Third objective, you are able to elicit requirements for a software product and translate these requirements into a documented design. Fourth objective, for studying this course is to recognize the importance of software reliability and how we design dependable software and what measures are used. Fifth objective is to understand the principles and techniques of the underlying processes for inspecting and testing software and making it free of errors and tolerable. Sixth objective, to understand the software quality assurance architectures and quality management standards and procedures. So first unit, introduction to software engineering. We start with the introduction to software engineering. So the objective of this unit is you are able to understand the software engineering processes and you are able to understand the different software components. You are able to know about the software characteristics of a good quality software. So software and engineering. So what is the software and what is engineering? Software is a collection of integrated programs and software subsists of carefully organized instructions and code written by developers on any of various particular languages. And engineering is the application of scientific and practical knowledge to invent, design, build, maintain frameworks, processes, etc. Another definition of software engineering is software engineering is an engineering branch related to the evolution of software product using well-defined scientific principles, techniques, and procedures. So the result of software engineering is an effective and reliable software product. Another definition, according to IEEE defines software engineering as the application of systematic, disciplined, quantifiable approach to the development, operation, and maintenance of software. So now we will find out the difference between a program and a software product. So what is the difference between a standalone program and software product? So program is a set of instructions related to each other. Product is a collection of program designed for specific tasks or to complete the specific task. And programs are defined by individuals for their personal use, whereas software product is a sum product which is usually developed by a group of engineers working as a team. Software program is usually of very small size. Software product usually of very large size. Programs are developed by single users, whereas software product is developed by large number of users. Single developer is there in case of programs, but for developing the software product, we need a team of developer. So software program lacks proper documentation, but to maintain the software products, we need good documentation support. In case of programs, ad hoc development is there, but in case of software product, keeping in their size in mind, we need the systematic development. Program lacks of user interface. Software product requires good user interface. Software programs are having limited functionality and software product exhibit more functionality. Importance of software engineering. So, software engineering to develop good quality software and large products, we need some engineering process which will guide us for the development of product in a better way, in a cost-effective manner, and is of good quality. So similarly, software engineering is very important. So we find out the importance of software engineering. First importance is it help us in handling the big project. Second, it increases the effectiveness for building a software products. It help us to build reliable software, and the software engineering decreases time to develop the software products. Software engineering processes reduces complexity and they minimize the soft development of software cost. So software engineering is important for two reasons. First, it produces reliable, trustworthy systems which are economically and able to build quickly. Second, using software engineering is very cheaper in the long run, and to use the software engineering methods are very useful for professional software systems. Failure to use software engineering methods leads to higher cost of testing, quality assurance, and long-term maintenance. So every software or every good quality software exhibits some basic characteristics. So what are those characteristics? So here in this slide we will discuss about those characteristics. So first is the operational characteristics. So operational characteristics deals with the operation of the software, how effectively your software operations. Then transition characteristics deals with the portability, usability, and transferability of your software. Revision characteristics, if you are making changes in your software and if it is not easy to change, then it is of no use. So revision characteristics defines the maintainability, testability, and flexibility. So first is operation characteristics. Under operational characteristics comes your different factors. First one is correctness, second is usability, third one integrity, fourth is efficiency, fifth is reliability, sixth security, and seventh is safety. So all, if your software exhibits all these characteristics, then your software is operationally good. Okay, then is your transition characteristics. So transition characteristics includes factors like usability, portability, and transferability. Then revision characteristics. Revision characteristics includes maintainability, testability, and flexibility. So thank you students. This is all for today's lecture. If you are having any queries, kindly mail me at kumar.naresh@galgotiasuniversity.edu.in. So in the next lecture, we will discuss about the software crisis.